Thank you. Thank you. Thank you to Missionary Baptist Church. I want to say first, thank you, Pastor Kirk, for the sermon that you delivered this morning.
Amen.
It was excellent. I want to thank you, Miss White, for telling me.
Amen.
And I will be here today to speak.
Amen.
I want to thank you, Zion, and Pastor Kirk, for accepting me. Amen. And I want to thank you, young students, for tolerating me. As was said earlier, somebody mentioned your next step. That's what I want to speak to you about, my next step. But before that, let's pray. Father, we come this afternoon to say thank you.
Thank you, Lord.
Thank you for the privilege, the opportunity, and the blessing for us to speak to these young people. Hopefully, Father, something will be said that they can take with them. Father, we pray that they continue to go forward in graduation, promotions, and the rest of their lives. We ask you, Father, to continue to bless them, God. Give them the Holy Spirit, the angel of the Lord. We ask this prayer in your Son, Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen. Amen.
I want to thank you for this program today. The young lady who played the violin earlier. Where I want to come from on your next step. I want to remind all of us that there was a time when we were a baby. And as a baby, we crawled before the Lord. We stood up, held up, we were able to stand alone, and then Then, after we started walking, we walked faster and faster, and we started running. We walked before we ran. Now we're worse. And there's a mental part of us, and there's a physical part of us. As a young baby, the physical part was just a development of the body. But God just kept us growing and maturing. There's a mental part of us. And as we get a little bit older, I mean, older, I mean 10 years, 12 years, 15 years. The mental part starts thinking. We start doing strategic thinking. We start planning for the future. That's our next step. We start setting goals. And we start thinking about what do I need to do to attain that. That's what I'm going to do. What we need to do to attain the next step. Now, having said that, we know, as we grow up, we know right from wrong. We talk. We know the good from bad and just from evil. So why do the evil from the bad and we know the right?
Right.
We also know that it's right to do the right thing because it's right to do the right thing. We know. So let's talk about these goals and how you accomplish these goals. We set goals sometimes as a teacher. We might set goals as a preacher. We might set goals as an electrician. But our goals are built around character. And why do we get that character? I want to speak more on the teacher because we spend more time with teachers and coaches sometimes than we do in the world. And what we do when we look at a teacher, we get a little bit of this teacher, a little bit of that teacher, a little bit of that teacher. A little bit of that deepness, a little bit from this preacher, a little bit from everybody. We take all of that and put it together and form our character. That's what we become. And as we go through life, we look back and as one person or two people, and we just sort of specify and say, I want to be like him, I want to be like her. Now, as we go through life, as you graduate from one grade to another grade, that's your next step. As you graduate from college, that's your next step. What are you going to do when you get there? What I ask you to do, along the way, one prayer. We always pray. We always ask God for guidance. But I ask you as you go, and from time to time, do an inventory of yourself. Sit down with a piece of paper. Write down your strengths. distractions, and direct down your strength, what you think your strengths are, and what you think your weaknesses are. You want to accentuate those strengths. You want to improve those strengths. And you want to attack those weaknesses, and check those weaknesses out, and put them on the side. Does that make sense? That's what you want to do as you go through life. Not do that. But you don't want, you don't want to forget the person or the people who have you, who guide you and direct you. And you're going to want to answer some stumbles. Have the stumbles as you go along the way. There are going to be some setbacks. Things are going to happen that you didn't anticipate. Things are just going to happen as the life goes. I'm reminded of Paul. Paul made a statement, I think it's in 2 Corinthians. He said, when I was a child,
yes, I guess it's true.
I spoke as a child. Yes. I understood as a child. I acted as a child. When I became a man, I grew up a child.
Yes.
That's what we want to go to. Education for us, as African Americans, black people, that's our key to get an education. We will not get ahead if you don't have an education.
Mm-hmm.
We will survive. We'll get by.
Yes.
We will not get ahead. Mm-hmm. You have to have an education. Not only that, but each of our generations, we know we want them to do better than the previous generation. Your grandparents wanted your parents to do better than they did. Your parents want you to do better than they did. There's nobody in this room, nobody that I can remotely imagine would not want the very, very best. Now, speaking of education, statistics show that a person with an education, college degree, over his lifetime, or her life, earns about $2.6 million over a lifetime. But there's a lot involved. But one who does not go to school earns about $1.4 million.
Mm-hmm.
That's almost twice as much. And you don't have to go to college. You can go to community school for college. And that's the choice. And your next step, you have to consider the grades that you make. Your SAT grade, or your ACT, ACT grades. Back to the education. There's nothing better than community college. You can almost go there for you. I know it's going to be more younger than home, but you can live at home. You can have a job. You can work. You can study. You can buy your car. You can get an associate degree. And then after that, if you decide, you can go to a four-year school for the next 2 years and get your education. So just keep that in mind. Last but not least. And Pastor Groves hit on this morning here in the hall. And that was Isaiah. He spoke in chapter 43. I want to mention chapter 40. I think it's about verse 28. When the prophet Isaiah was talking to the Israelites, while they were in Babylon, and he was telling them that God is your Savior. He's your crew, he's your provider. He does everything for you. And finally he said, have you not seen, have you not heard that God is our everlasting Lord, who created the earth from end to end? He never gets weary, he never gets tired. And his understanding is unfathomable for us to understand. That he gives strength to the weary and increases the power. Why all this? It's just even youth who are tired and young people stumble and fall. Those who walk in the Lord.
Yes.
Who renew their strength.
Yes, sir.
Amen.
Renew their strength. They will soar like wings on people.
Yes.
Who are running out of the river. And they will walk. That's you, young people. trials and tribulations. He was a young person, doing a little time. Father, if they have faith in you, speak of the Lord and renew that faith. Renew that strength. They will soar.